NCIS. What's up everyone, General Discharge here. Today's video is going to be discussing the NCIS. No, not the show. We're talking the real deal. There we go. NCIS stands for Naval Criminal Investigative Service. It is the primary law enforcement agency of the Department of the Navy. We're going to go over what they do, their capabilities, training, requirements, REACT teams, and much more. If you want the scoop on the NCIS, sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. Before we jump into it, make sure to take a moment and show us some love and support by liking our video and subscribing to our channel. Your support is our lifeblood. Do not hesitate to ask us questions in the comments section below. We check everything. NCIS has primary responsibility for investigating actual, suspected, or alleged major criminal offenses. It also has exclusive investigative jurisdiction within the Department of the Navy for actual, potential, or suspected acts of espionage, terrorism, sabotage, assassination, or defection by naval personnel. Their special agents are authorized by law to conduct arrests of both military members and civilians, both on and off military installations. They also provide full-time protection details on key Department of the Navy personnel, such as the Secretary of the Navy, Commandant of the Marine Corps, and the Chief of Naval Operations. And, fun fact, NCIS is a part of the FBI's Joint Terrorism Task Force. So, where's their jurisdiction? Where do they operate? The NCIS operates in both the United States and around the world. For this video, we're going to stick with just talking about the regions the field offices have in the US. The Northeast Field Office covers this region, the DC office covers this region, the Norfolk one covers this, the Carolinas one covers here, the Southeast one here, the Central one covers all of this, the Northwest covers this, Marine West this, and the Southwest is this. And then there's Hawaii, which also covers Guam. Here are all of the field offices' headquarters too, for your viewing pleasure. Now that you know where they operate, let's go over the structure of the NCIS. The NCIS has its headquarters, the Behavioral Science Group, Office of Military Support, and its operational directorates. The headquarters is straightforward. That's the main hub. It's located in Quantico, Virginia. The BSG supports the NCIS headquarters and field offices on a worldwide basis by deploying licensed psychologists with specialized training and experience in law enforcement psychology and national security. They are responsible for providing consultations to operations, investigations, and related projects and matters. The OMS is composed of active duty and reserve U.S. Navy officers and enlisted personnel. They perform in a variety of mission support areas in NCIS offices throughout the world, including protective service operations, supply and logistics, communications, administrative duties, intelligence, and security. Then there's the operational directorates, which are either considered functional or field. These directorates are responsible for criminal investigations, counterintelligence, counterterrorism, biometrics, technical surveillance countermeasures, behavioral science, technical services, polygraph services, and forensics. The directorates of NCIS are these. Pause the screen to take a longer look. Now that you know the areas of operation of the NCIS and what makes up the NCIS, let's go over another part of their makeup, the NCIS Special Agents. About half of the NCIS consists of their special agents, but they also have intelligence analysts, cyber specialists, and careers in forensics, information technology, and administrative support. We're going to mainly focus on the special agents for this video, but feel free to check out their website if you want to learn more about the other careers. This is the badge of an NCIS Special Agent. NCIS Special Agents gain broad law enforcement experience and are given responsibility early on in their careers. They travel the globe and may even be stationed aboard a ship. Yeah, you heard that right. It's called Special Agents Afloat. A special agent can be stationed on a carrier, amphib, or a hospital ship, and pretty much do their job they do anywhere else in a floating city, as they call it. They also provide professional investigative, counterintelligence, and force protection support to deploy Navy and Marine Corps commanders on the ships. It's some pretty cool stuff. Now before we move on to the training and requirements to join the NCIS, we gotta talk about their REACT teams, which are their special operations entity. Did you know General Discharge has an Instagram? We actively post memes, video updates, and whatever else we feel like. Join the team and follow us at general.discharge. Links in the description. Now back to the video. REACT stands for Regional Enforcement Action Capabilities Training. REACT is designed to respond to high-risk operations that involve the service of arrest and search warrants, undercover agent and source protection and rescue, undercover operations, rural operations, high-risk surveillance, and high-risk protective assignments. REACT consists of three regional teams that currently entail a team commander, deputy commander, supervisory special agent, and numerous REACT operators. REACT personnel are trained in diverse tactical disciplines to include operational planning, intelligence gathering, precision marksmanship, breaching, hostage rescue, dynamic and covert entry techniques, personal security operations, and a variety of other disciplines. So yeah, REACT teams are pretty freaking cool. Alright, let's go over the training you'll go through to become an NCIS Special Agent. Just keep in mind that the hiring process can take up to a year to complete. You'll have to complete the Criminal Investigators Training Program and Special Agent Basic Training Program aboard the Federal Law Enforcement Training Center in Glencoe, Georgia. In addition, special agents are required to successfully pass the Physical Efficiency Battery and score at a minimum 25th percentile in each component area for their age and gender. If you're wondering what the PEB standards are, we'll leave a link for you in the description. Now for the requirements. Here are the requirements to become an NCIS Special Agent. Pause the screen to take a longer look. So there you go. You now know a lot about NCIS. The real NCIS, that is. Now don't go just yet. We got some more information for you. If you're interested in other US law enforcement agencies and entities, we've done videos on some of them. We got a video on the US Marshals, Border Patrol, Secret Service, the FBI's Hostage Rescue Team, the FBI's SWAT teams, ATF, and we even did a video comparing the FBI and CIA. Go check them out if you haven't already. Well, that is the down and dirty of NCIS. If you learned something from this video, make sure to give us a like and subscribe to our channel. As always, thank you for watching. Do you even want to be here? A big shout out to all of our patrons over at our Patreon. Thank you all so much for taking the extra step in supporting our channel. It is much appreciated. If you'd like to be featured on a General Discharge video, go give our Patreon a look and join the team. Here's Nick Nausea.
All your friends are subscribing to General Discharge, and you don't even want to be here.